Good, except when the value of the x-coordinate is equal to or less than the value of 1. Yes, Isaac?
What about that problem?
Oh, that? Don't worry about that.
Why?
I just put that up as a joke. That's probably the hardest geometry equation in the world.
Well, how much extra credit is it worth?
Well, considering I've never seen anyone get it right, including my mentor, Dr. Leakey at MIT, I guess if anyone here can solve that problem, I'd see to it that none of you ever have to open another math book again for the rest of your lives. Max? Here to try it?
I'm sorry, did someone say my name?
You guys have it real easy. I never had it like this where I grew up. But I send my kids here because the fact is, you go to one of the best schools in the country, Rushmore. Now, for some of you, it doesn't matter. You were born rich and you're going to stay rich. But here's my advice to the rest of you. Take dead aim on the rich ones. Get them in the crosshairs and take them down. Just remember, they can buy anything, but they can't buy backbone. Don't let them forget it. Thank you.
Congratulations, Herman. Perhaps you could give us an encore. Nicholas Copernicus.
Give a shit.
My favorite whole damn native term, at least these little pricks can do is hear me out.
Hi, Dr. Guggenheim.
Hello, Max.
Hello, I'm Max Fischer. I just wanted to say that I strongly agree with your views concerning Rushmore. Your speech was excellent.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello.
Oh, Mr. Boone, this is my chapel partner, Dirk Calloway.
Nice to meet you, Dirk.
Well, thanks. You know, I really think you're right about Rushmore. Come on, Dirk.
What's his name again?
Max Fischer.
Sharp little guy.
He's one of the worst students we've got.
Everybody leave it here. My lyrics.
We're putting you on what we call sudden death academic probation.
And what does that entail?
It entails that if you fail another class, you'll be asked to leave Rushmore.
In other words, I'll be expelled.
That's correct.
Could I see some documentation on that, please?
Too many extracurricular activities, Max. Not enough studying.
54 over 241. Mm-hmm. Dr. Guggenheim, I don't want to tell you how to do your job, but the fact is, no matter how hard I try, I still might flunk another class. And if that means I have to stay on for a postgraduate year, then so be it.
But we don't offer a postgraduate year.
Well, we don't offer it yet.
Just bring up the grades.
You remember how I got into this school?
Yes. You wrote a play.
That's right. Second grade. A little one-act about Watergate. And my mother read it and felt I should go to Rushmore. And you read it and gave me a scholarship, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
Did you regret it?
No, I don't regret it. But I still might have to expel you.
Couldn't we just let me float by? For all time's sake?
Can't do it, Max.
You want to kick me out?
Oh, no, not again. What are you going to do?
The only thing I can do, try and pull some strings with the administration, I guess. Did you hear they're teaching Japanese next year?
That's the rumor.
And they're canceling Latin.
What?
I tried to get Latin canceled for 5 years.
It's a dead language, I'd always say.
Well, I guess they finally heard you. Excuse me.
Can I please see a list of all the people who've checked out this book in the past year?
Why?
Look at that.
I have seen wicked men and fools, a great many of both, and I believe they both get paid in the end. But the fools first. Chapter 15.
Meet me on the corner in 10 minutes.
Where are you going?
I'll tell you in the squad car. Oh, and Willie. We were wrong about Enrique Sanchez. He died in his sleep.
Excellent. That was excellent. That was great. That was great. Irving, could you get some root beers for anybody who wants one? I don't want one, okay? All right, next scene. Frank, you enter stage right with the bag of cocaine.
I was just telling Mr. Calloway the other day how fortunate we are to have someone like you looking after Dirk.
Oh, don't be silly. Dirk's a great kid, and I'm just trying to impart some of the experiences I've accrued to help him. This has my number on it. If you need to call me or need help at Dirk or anything like that.
Well, thank you very much. Hello, Dirk.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, okay. How are you, honey?
Fine.
Bye.
Bye. It's so nice to see you again.
Hey, Dirk. How'd your math test go?
What math test?
I thought you had a math test today.
No, did you turn in your paper on the Berlin airlift?
Yeah, I got an extension.
Hey, George. So how'd it go with Mrs. Calloway?
We shook hands.
Big deal.
I didn't give her my phone number.
Buckin said he'd have already banged her by now.
What? Just to let the form Scottish gorilla to shut his fat face. That's my best friend's mother he's talking about.
I always thought that's why you picked Dirk as your chapel partner.
What are you, a lawyer?
Hey, Mr. Bloom.
Hey, it's Max Fischer.
Oh, hi.
Hey, Max, my mom just showed up. Is it okay if I leave early? Over.
Sure, Charlie.
What's the secret, Max?
The secret?
Yeah, well, you seem to have it pretty figured out.
Secret? I don't know. I think you just gotta find something you love to do and then do it for the rest of your life. For me, it's going to Rushmore.
Shotgun.
Hey, Ronnie. Hey, Donnie. Hey, good.
Get in the back. I say shotgun.
Get in the back, Donnie.
Let's go. you invite that kid to your party?
Max Fischer.
Come on, Dad. There's going to be girls there. I'd rather die.
Pull your head out of your ass.
Did I miss you, little Gene?
Goodbye, Gene.
I'll see you tomorrow. May I see the bag, please?
That's it.
Thank you. I need a signature on this geometry test, by the way.
Hmm. 37.
I don't know what to do anymore.
It could have been worse. You almost got the A.
Almost got the A, Dad. What are you writing? Maybe I'm spending too much of my time starting up clubs and putting on plays.
That's possible.
I should probably be trying harder to score chicks. That's the only thing anybody really cares about. It's not my forte, unfortunately.
It'll happen, Max. It's just, you're like one of those clipper ship captains. You're married to the sea.
Yes, that's true. But I've been out to sea for a long time. Hello.
Hi. I like your hat.
Oh, thank you. You're a teacher here, aren't you? And this is your first year at Rushmore, Dave.
Uh-huh.
And how long have you been a smoker, if you don't mind me asking?
Well, let's see now. How old are you?
15.
Since I was your age.
You're kidding. You should quit.
You're right.
And I should buy my own business. You go to school, by the way.
Harvard.
Really? That's a coincidence. My top schools where I want to apply to are Oxford and the Sorbonne. My safety's Harvard.
That's very ambitious.
Thank you.
What do you want to study?
Well, I haven't decided for sure, but probably a double major in mathematics and pre-med. What was your major?
I didn't have a major, but my thesis was on Latin American economic policy.
Oh, that's interesting. Did you hear they're not going to teach Latin here anymore?
This was more like Central America.
Oh, Central America and whatnot. Well, moving on, they're going to cancel Latin. They've got to make room for Japanese.
That's a shame because all the Romance languages are based in Latin.
Yeah, they are, aren't they?
Nihilo sanctum est ne.
What's that? Oh, it's Latin. What does that mean?
It's nothing sacred.
Sic transit gloria. Glory fades. I'm Max Fischer.
Hi.
Hi.
Come on, bye now.
Sic transit gloria.
All right.
You to me are sweet as roses in the morning. You to me are soft as summer in the
morning. It's the reason I have any question. Isn't that good?
The sidewalks and the street.
Why didn't you just press so fresh on your belly, you skip mop? Is that Latin?
Oh, again! What?
Never in my wildest imagination did I ever dream I would have sons like these. What's your dad doing, Max?
He's a neurosurgeon at St. Joseph's Hospital. Personally, I could never see myself cutting open somebody's brain, but he seems to enjoy it. Oh, no. I got this one. So you were in Vietnam, if I'm not mistaken?
Yeah.
Were you in the shit?
Yeah, I was in the shit.
See you Sunday, Mr. Bloom.
Right.
What's on Sunday? Oh, that's right, the twins' birthday party.
Do you want to come?
I'd love to, except I've already got a previous application to attend to. Yeah. Thanks for the invitation, though.
Come work for me.
What do you mean?
I mean, I could use someone like you.
Look, I may not be rich, Mr. Bloom. My father may only be a doctor, but we manage.
112s!
Excuse me, Mr. Bloom. Last time. You're on the team? I'm an alternate. Hey, good to see you again.
You know, as per our conversation of the day?
Latin.
Right, the Romance languages? Well, I gave a little speech.
I heard about this.
Oh, you did?
I understand you made a very convincing argument.
I just thought you'd be pleased to hear that they're going to continue the Latin program.
I'm very impressed.
Thank you very much. Hey, you need an assistant?
Do we get to have an assistant around here?
No, I doubt it. I'm on scholarship, though. Academic scholarship, so I get to do odd jobs. Say, how'd you decide to teach at Rushmore?
My husband went here.
I didn't know you were married.
Well, he's dead now, so I'm not, actually.
When did he die?
Last year.
My mother's dead.
I'm sorry to hear that.
She died when I was 7. We both have dead people in our families. Now, what's going on in here?
These were just moving.
I don't want Ellis. I want to steal. I don't give a rat's ass what you said. Steal, Harry.
So you changed your mind and you want the job?
No, I've got an idea and I need some money.
The Westmore leads is an aquarium! A first class aquarium where the scientist can lecture and the student can observe the marine life in its natural habitat!
What do you think, Billy?
An aquarium? What kind of fish?
Barracuda, stingrays, electric eels, trout, hammerheads, piranha, giant squid, octopus.
Piranhas, really?
Yes, I was talking to a guy in South America.
What did you have to say?
Nothing. I thought I should go to you first.
What?
Because at this moment I feel the best strategy is to keep a low profile. The more preparation work I can do, the stronger our case will be when we take it to the administration.
How much money do you want?
$35,000 for the initial plans.
I'll give you $2,500.
Okay.
Summer breeze, showing off their silver leaves as we walked by. Soft kisses on a summer's day, laughing all our cares away, just you and I. Sweet, sleepy warm love summer nights, gazing at the distant lights.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Can I ask you something?
Sure.
Has it ever crossed your mind that you're far too young for me?
It crossed my mind that you might consider that a possibility, yeah?
Quite apart from the fact that you're a student.
I'm not trying to pressure you into anything, Miss Cross. I'm surprised you brought it up so bluntly.
I just want to make sure.
We've become friends, haven't we?
Yes.
Good.
And,
The truth is, neither one of us had the slightest idea where this relationship is going. We can't predict the future.
We don't have a relationship, Max.
But we're friends.
Yes, and that's all we're going to be.
That's all I meant by relationship. You want me to grab a dictionary?
No, I just want to make sure that we understand each other.
I understand. You're not attracted to me. See, lovey?
Max, you're 15 years old. Attraction doesn't enter into it.
If you say so. Look, all I'm getting at is that I've never met anyone like you. So you can take that for whatever it's worth.
I think I can safely say I've never met anyone like you either.
You haven't, have you? Wanna shake hands? I'm glad we had this conversation.
So am I.
I can't wear a wire, they're filling me up every day.
Oh, come on, Frank. You have complete protection.
Yeah, I've heard that one before. I gotta put a dime in the meter.
Sit down, Frank. Joe, go put a dime in the meter for Officer Serpico.
Look, Serpico, if you agree to testify and open
no!
The door,
no, what?
No, I'm not gonna testify.
Well, Inspector Gunn is bad at my desk. Come to me one thing, O'Reilly, name it. You're gonna follow this thing all the way to the end of the line where I got to be. So help me God.
I've got something.
This could be it.
It's Ash across the street.
Yeah,
it's him. It's
no man. Get on the L train.
Take it!
What happened to the canola line?
Max, you're supposed to say forget about it, Sanchez. The old man likes his canola.
Look, I made a mistake, all right? It didn't make any difference anyway.
Hey, I'm letting it go. But don't say it doesn't matter. Every line matters.
Get off my back!
I want to talk to my player! Guys, break it up.
Tonight was excellent.
Thanks. Well, it was better in rehearsals. I'll catch up with you later, Dad. I got a dinner to go to.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Casting crew on me.
Oh, you need some money?
No, Dad.
Well, that was a slap.
It was good.
Here he is. Max, that was great.
I'm so glad you could come.
I want you to meet a friend of mine, Peter Flynn, Max Fischer.
Hi. Who's this guy?
Peter.
I really liked your play. It was really cool.
What happened to your nose?
Oh, I had a personal face. What's your excuse?
Hey, Arthur.
How you doing?
Nice job.
Thank you.
Want to get to meet your dad tonight?
Oh, no, the old man's on call. Mr. Bloom, I'd like you to meet Miss Cross, and I didn't catch this young gentleman's name. I like your nurse's uniform, guy.
These are OR scrubs.
Oh, are they? Well, they're totally inappropriate for the occasion.
Well, I didn't know we were going to dinner.
That's because you weren't invited.
Take it easy, Max.
You were the one that ordered him whiskey and soda.
So what's wrong with that? I can write a hit play. Why can't I have a little drink to unwind myself? So tell me, Curly, how do you know Miss Cross?
We went to Harvard together.
Oh, that's great. I wrote a hit play and directed it. So I'm not sweating it either.
Can we get a check, please?
What do you think you're doing?
Getting a check.
No, you're not. Excuse me. I just want to thank you for accommodating us. You see, we only thought we were going to be three, but someone invited himself along, so I apologize.
Quite all right, sir.
Okay.
Very well.
You're being rude, Max.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not. I'm just trying to figure out why you brought this gentleman to my play and my dinner, which was invitation only.
Would you like me to pass you the creamer, Doc?
Yes, please.
What is wrong with you?
What is wrong with you? You hurt my feelings. This night was important to me.
How did I hurt your feelings?
Oh, my God! I wrote a hit play!
And I'm in love with you.
Are you hiding over there?
I don't want to disrupt class. What's that you're painting?
That's a jellyfish.
What can I do for you, Mr. Bloom?
Max wants to talk to you.
What for?
To apologize, I think.
Should we talk over here? He sent you?
Yeah.
Are you his messenger?
No, I'm his friend. You were right. I should not have allowed him to drink.
I don't think I should see Max anymore.
Well, he's not going to like the sound of that.
No, I know, but I think I let him get too attached. What do you think?
Well, I think you did your best.
Tell him I'm sorry.
Okay. What is your first name?
Rosemary. What's yours?
Herman. He wrote you a letter.
Dear Miss Cross, I would like to take this opportunity to formally apologize for the events of the night of the 23rd. I'm not accustomed to drinking alcohol. Please do me the service of coming to the unveiling of a new venture I've undertaken. I hope you will attend. If possible, I remain your friend, Max Fischer.
Cut the music and no more pictures. What time is it, Alan?
1:15.
Excuse me, gentlemen. Hey, lay off the chip, Buckin. Did you see her?
She's not here.
Well, go check her classroom.
Should I go ahead and take care of this tree?
Let's wait a few minutes.
What's going on here, Maxie?
Oh, hey, Coach. That's good to see you. This is where I'm putting in a new aquarium. I'm in charge of the committee, if you believe it.
This is my baseball diamond.
Yeah, I know, and I believe it's been relocated a few feet over.
Is it true the aquarium will have piranhas?
Where'd you hear that?
My source indicated that it was a possibility.
Yes, it's true, but piranhas are a very tricky species.
Max?
Excuse me, Doris.
Bad news.
What's the story?
She had a substitute teacher today.
Why?
I guess she got sick.
You know she's not sick. Give me the phone. Janet, Max Fischer, Mr. Bloom there? Well, where is he? Goddamn, he's supposed to be here. I don't give a shit about the barracuda. Fuck it. I'm building it anyway.
Max!
Oh, hello, Dr. Rubenstein.
How do you do? I'm
having a fundraiser for the...
Turn that damn thing off!
Tell me this isn't happening.
Dr. Guggenheim, I'd rather not have this conversation in front of my crew.
Asked to say a few words to the class. Max, you want to take it away?
Sure, thanks very much. I just want to introduce myself. I'm Max Fischer. I'm a former student of Rushmore Academy, which I recently got expelled from. This is my first time in a public school. I know you probably think I was born with a silver spoon in my mouth. But I'm no elitist. I think you've got some great facilities. I'm really looking forward to making the best of it here at Grover Cleveland. One footnote. I notice you have a fencing team. Well, I'm going to try my hardest to start one up for you guys.
Max?
Yes?
Hi, I'm Margaret Yang. I'm in Mrs. Whitney's class. I just wanted to tell you that I liked your speech.
Thank you.
I don't think I've ever heard of anyone asking to give a speech in class before.
No? How unfortunate.
The silver spoon remark might rub some people the wrong way.
But what do you mean?
Well,
you know what? Look, I gotta go to class. I'll see you later, Mrs. Chang. Jen, Max Fischer is in.
Yeah. Okay. Hey, Max, how's it going?
Terrible. Tell me something. When you talked to Miss Cross yesterday...
Do you have a telephone pass? Yes. Excuse me. Do you have a telephone pass?
1 second.
I gotta tell you, I don't know what you see in her. I don't think she's right for you.
What's that supposed to mean?
I mean, she's not that beautiful. She's not... that intriguing. I mean, she has something that you can't put your finger on, but...
Look, Mr. Bloom, your comments are valuable, but let's get to the point, son. Will she see me again, yes or no?
No.
Hang on. I'm talking on the telephone. Oh, come on. That's rude.
Fischer,
you better beat it, Sonny. You know, Fischer, I've been watching you. Showboat, always talking, picking a kid like Duck because his mother's a great piece and then getting nowhere. Like everything you do. Big show, no results.
What do you call getting a hand job from Mrs. Calloway in the back of her Jaguar?
A fucking lie?
You think I got kicked out for just the aquarium? Nah, it was the hand job. You want to know something else? It was worth it. I'm sorry I embarrassed you at dinner. And please apologize to what's-his-name for me.
I will. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. But I miss Rushmore. I miss the seasons. Watching the leaves change. By the way, what time does the library close? I've got an overdue book to turn in. That is your handwriting, isn't it?
My husband gave me this book when he came to visit England when I was 13. And he went to Rushmore, so when he died, I gave it to the library here. You remind me of him, you know?
I do? How?
How? You were a member of the Rushmore Beekeepers, weren't you?
Yeah, I was president of them.
Who founded that club?
Do you think we can be friends again, Miss Grass? In a strictly platonic way?
Of course I do. Do you think you can make a go of it and settle down at Grover Cleveland?
Yeah, but I need a tutor.
In the midnight moonlight, I'd be walking along the lonely mile. And every time I do, I keep seeing this picture of you. Here comes my baby. Here she comes now. And this will come as no surprise to me. Let it never die. Here comes my baby. Here she comes now. Walking with a love that's all so fine. Never could be mine. No matter how I try.
Got the birds for your approval.
I'll take the ruler.
And here's the knife.
That's too fake.
Hi, Max.
Hello.
What's your name again?
Margaret Yang.
Margaret Yang. What are you doing seventh period, Margaret Yang?
I have guitar lessons.
Classical guitar, and what school?
Rock.
Rock, that's good, we can get you out of that. Could I see you get your glasses on, please? Let's put Margaret down for 3:30 out of 20, Woody.
Thank you.
And bring a headshot, please.
Hello, Herman.
How are you, Rosemary?
I'm fine, thanks. I just got home and I'm having a little snack.
Having some carrots?
Yeah.
Nice house.
Yeah, it isn't mine. I'm just sort of house-sitting. You're in the neighborhood?
Did Max have something planned for us today? A trip to a museum or something?
So, I think he's rehearsing tonight.
Oh, that's right. He's doing his new play. Yeah, he's really making a go of it over there at Grover Cleveland.
Yeah, he's doing very well, isn't he? Do you want a carrot?
Yeah, I'll have one of those. Well, I'll probably be seeing you soon.
Or we could go for a walk now, if you like.
Sure.
Weather's nice, isn't it? A little brisk. I'll just get a sweater. I'll be back in a minute.
Who needs friends?
You're standing up for the wrong guy. Fisher ain't your mate.
What are you talking about, fucking?
He thinks your mum's good for a bunk. That's the only reason he picked you as his chapel partner.
Who sold you that crack?
He told me himself. He says she gave him a hand job in the back seat of her bloody Jaguar.
Max, you never say that.
Yeah, I suppose you're right. After all, the son of a brain doctor doesn't need to impress anybody now, does he?
The killing's gonna start, Bessie. It's getting too local. No more gas.
Nigga, you're the crazy one. People were trying to kill you. Right time, are you gonna get rid of your gun?
It's time, homie.
Kiss me, little one.
All right, then, kisses on the lap.
Okay.
Is that for me?
Dear Max, I'm sorry to say that I have secretly found out that Mr. Bloom is having an affair with Miss Cross. My first suspicions came when I saw them Frenching in front of her house, and then I knew for sure when they went skinny dipping in Mr. Bloom's swimming pool, giving each other hand jabs while you were taking a nap on the front porch. Why am I telling you this now? Because you're such a good friend. Take care, pal. Fondly, Dirk Calloway.
God.
How was she, Herman?
Jesus Christ.
Was she good? I bet she was. Although I wouldn't know because I never screwed her. Going skinny dipping while I took a nap. Are you comfortable, Max? I'll just be out back nude getting hand jobs from the woman you love.
You never went skinny dipping.
Sure you didn't. And next you're gonna tell me you didn't just walk out of her house at 2:00 in the morning.
I'm in love with her. Well, I was in love with her first. And, all that crap about... I don't think she's that great. I don't think she's right for you, Max. That was all bullshit, wasn't it? Do you think she's in love with you?
I don't know.
Well, I guarantee you she's not. And she never will be.
Max.
I save Latin.
What did you ever do?
On the planet I come from, the sun only comes out once a year.
A tiny piece of colored glass.
That is why my skin...
My love was born.
Oh, I'm sorry, I just came by to thank you for wrecking my life.
And reds and golds and yellows. Where the colors...
Max, what are you doing?
Night brought on its purple cloak of velvet to the sky. And the gulls were wheeling, spinning.
Hello, Mrs. Blue, Mrs. Max Fischer. I have some information regarding your husband. Please return my call and my voicemail to Grover Cleveland High School, Extension 23. Thank you very much.
Thank you for meeting me.
You're welcome.
Would you like a sandwich?
All right.
I have a tuna... And peanut butter and jelly. Sorry, it's a little exotic.
Take a tuna fish.
No grapples.
Get to the point.
And how long will you be staying with us, Mr. Blair?
Indefinitely. I'm being sued for divorce.
Very good, sir.
Yo, Shorty! Say, can you tell me where the pool's located? I might want to take a dip after I have dinner and hit the bar.
It's on the roof, sir.
Rushmore, I gotta go get a teacher fight.
I don't think that's wise, Max.
What are you doing? What are you doing? Private property, you're trespassing! What are you, crazy?
Wait a minute!
Stop!
Let's have a truce for a second!
Wait, truce! Truce!
What's this all about?
Did you say my mom gave you a hand job?
What?
Did you say it?
Who told you that goddamn lie? Never mind, I know who said it. But I'm gonna stick a knife in his heart. I'm gonna send him back to Ireland in a body bag.
He's from Scotland.
Well, tell that stupid Mick he just made my list of things to do today. I'm gonna pop a cap in his ass. So you received the package? Good. I just wanted to inform you about what's going on.
I never took you for an informer, Max.
What's that supposed to mean?
What's that supposed to mean? She resigned this morning before you even got your little snapshots. So your latest attempt at sabotage backfired.
She's one of the best teachers you've got. How could you let her go?
Why are you trying to get her fired?
Stupid old fool! I'm trying to win her back! Miss Cross?
Hi, Max.
Need any help?
No, I have it.
Oh, here, let me see.
No, please, look, I don't think you should come in here. Look, I'm sorry I hurt your feelings. I'm sorry I love your friend instead of you, but... Please, Max.
You honestly believe you love Bloom instead of me?
Yes.
You'll have to forgive me if I don't take your word for that.
Oh, stop.
Miss Cross.
Listen, if you don't stop, I'm going to lose it. I mean it.
It's too late. It's too late.
Oops.
Wait, please. I got kicked out because of you.
No, you got kicked out.
Rushmore was my life. Now you are.
No, I'm not. What do you really think is going to happen between us? Do you think we're going to have sex?
That's a kind of cheap way to put it.
Not if you've ever fucked before, it isn't.
Oh my God.
How would you describe it to your friends? Would you say that you fingered me? Or maybe I could give you a handjob, but that put an end to all of this. Please get out of my classroom.
Fischer, you spotty wee fucker.
Hey, Magnus.
Got any good hand jobs lately? Hey, Dirk, look who's here. It's your stepfather, waiting for your mom so that he can get a piece.
Your mind's warped as your ear, Buckin.
Don't get nasty, brother.
Got him, Dirk. I got him.
Back.
Oh, hey, Mr. Bloom.
You said you wanted to meet?
When?
Right now. You said you wanted to put an end to all this.
Oh, yeah. I was going to try and have that tree over there fall on you.
That big one?
Yep.
It would have flattened me like a pancake. What stopped you?
What's the point? She loves you.
She's my Rushmore, Max.
Yeah, I know. She was mine, too.
I am waiting, I am waiting, over here, over here. I am waiting, over here, over here. Waiting for someone to come out of somewhere. Waiting for someone to come out of somewhere. You can't hold out. You can't hold out. Over here, over here. You can't hold out. You can't hold out. Over here, over here. Waiting for someone to come out of somewhere. Waiting for someone to come out of somewhere.
Company here at the shop, Max. You put any more thought into giving school another shot?
No.
Max, I like being a barber. I'm good at it. But I always thought you'd try another line of work. You talked about being a senator or a diplomat.
Pipe dreams, Dad. I'm a barber, son.
See you at dinner.
Do for you?
I thought I might get a haircut.
What clothes?
Well, I just want to say I'm sorry I threw rocks at you that day. But I guess I'll go now. Merry Christmas.
What in the hell's that?
Did you hear the news?
I doubt it. I don't really follow the news anymore.
Dr. Guggenheim had a stroke.
I'll send him a box of candy.
Maybe I ought to go visit him.
Mrs. Guggenheim?
Hello, Max. Come in. So good to see you. Oh, these are glorious. I'll put them in some water. Have a seat.
Should I say hello to Dr. Guggenheim, or can he not hear me?
No, he can hear you.
Hey, old-timer. It's, Max Fischer. You probably can't hear me because I don't know if your brain is damaged or...
What do you want?
Nelson?
Uh-huh.
That's the first thing he said in 10 days.
Do you think he recognized me?
Oh, I don't think so.
It's Fischer.
See you later. Bye, I hope you get that.
Hey, amigo.
So who gave you the shiner?
Either Ronnie or Donnie. I can't tell the difference anymore.
Well, whichever one it was really clocked you.
Kids don't like it when their parents get divorced.
I don't blame them.
Neither do I.
How is she?
I really wouldn't know.
Why not?
I haven't seen her in 6 weeks.
What happened? She left?
She's in love with a dead guy anyway.
Edward Appleby.
You know, he's sweet, but she's fucked up. Adios, muchacho.
Hey, are you okay?
I'm a little bit lonely these days.
Jesus, it came at me to nowhere. It was so sudden.
What?
I'm sorry, can I use your phone? I just got hit by a car.
Oh, my God. Are you okay?
What did you say?
Come inside.
Thank you.
I'm going to get something for your head.
So this is where it all happens.
Well, what happens?
I don't know. So why'd you dump Bloom?
That's none of your business.
I know it's not. But I just got hit by a car and I'm a little confused right now. I mean, I thought you dumped me for Bloom, then I
never dumped you because we were never going out.
It would just help me if you talked to me for a minute. Tell me what happened.
A. He's married. B. He hates himself. And C, well, he smashed up your bicycle, didn't he?
My previous bicycle, yes.
Well, what sort of person does something like that?
I don't know. Ward does funny things to men. He thinks he dumped him because of Edward Appleby.
What does that mean?
Well, I mean, you live in his room. With all his stuff, it's kind of...
I was married to him.
I know.
Although I will say that Edward has more spark and character and imagination in one fingernail than Herman Bloom has in his entire body.
One dead fingernail.
Right. One dead fingernail.
How did he die, by the way?
He drowned. How did your mother die?
She got cancer.
Hold still for a moment, okay?
You're very pretty.
Thank you. Is this fake blood?
Yes, it is.
You know, you and Hammond deserve each other. You're both little children. Let me show you the door.
I just got back up the window.
Goodbye, Miss Cross.
Goodbye, Max.
Sorry about what I said about your mom giving me a hand job.
I know, Max. Sorry I didn't take your hand when Buckman kicked your ass.
Hey, it's okay.
What's that?
I don't know. Nice landing. What's that you got there? A little fly plan or something? Pretty good. Do you know Dirk Calloway?
I don't think so.
Dirk? This is Margaret Yang. I heard about your science project on Action 13. You said the Navy wants to buy it from you.
No, not anymore.
Why not?
Because it was a fake.
What do you mean?
I faked all the results.
Why?
Because it didn't work. I thought it would, but it didn't. You're a real jerk to me, you know that?
Sorry.
Well, anyway, nice to see you.
To the right, to the right,
Duncan Wright,
Margaret Yang, Wade Jackson,
Shoshana. Where I'll end up, what I think, only God will know. I've sat up in the setting sun, but never, 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 never. I never wanted what it was, but never, never, never. To my words, but they fall far below.
Thanks for meeting you, Mr. Bloom.
What can I do for you?
I let my music take me where my heart wants to go.
What's this?
I slam upon the devil's. That's the perfect attendance award and the punctuality award. I got those at Rushmore. I thought you could choose which one you liked more, and you could wear that one and I could wear the other.
Never, 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 never.
Come on inside.
Well, 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 well. Look at the cat right there.
Sorry I'm late. I want you to meet someone. Mr. Bloom, this is my father, Bert Fischer.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Fischer.
Now, Mr. Fisher was my father's name. Call me Bert, please.
Okay, Bert.
So, Max tells me you need a haircut. I can see that. Why don't you sit down and have a look?
I don't know, Bert.
Don't worry, Mr. Bloom. It's a relatively painless procedure. Maybe we'll throw in a shave as well. Okay. Are you fond of that mustache? You think you want to keep it for a while?
How much are you worth, by the way?
I don't know.
Over 10 million?
Yeah, I guess so.
Good, good.
What?
Because we're going to need all of it.
$8 million for
this. And that's all you're prepared to spend? I'm sorry you couldn't make it to a little groundbreaking the other day. It's kind of a shame since he's building it for you.
Well, you know, I never asked anyone to build me an aquarium. I'm not quite sure how that rumor got started.
Me neither. You think Edward Appleby would have built one for you?
Yeah, I think he would have if he'd had the money.
That's what I thought. Bloom's got a bit more spark and vitality than you expected, doesn't he?
I thought the aquarium was your idea.
Well, I gave it to my friend.
15 sticks?
Yes, please. And could you make the order out to Ready Demolition, Tucson, Arizona? Thank you very much.
Make sure these don't get wet.
See you 3:15.
Where are you going?
Rushmore. I've got one last piece of unfinished business to attend to.
Ah! Fisher, you fuck!
Hello, Magnus. I'd have shot you in the other ear, but it got blown off a long time ago. Besides, now we're even.
Huh. No for long, Kimasabi.
We'll see. I got a proposition for you.
Well, you can stick it up your mother's arse, you little prick.
I gotta hand it to you, Magnus. You got away with words. You want to be in a play?
What's all this shite?
Nothing. I just think you're right for the part.
I always wanted to be in one of your fucking plays.
I know you did, mate.
This is gonna be exciting. My son Max wrote it.
Oh boy, I gotta call the hospital.
Excuse me, English teacher?
Yes.
Hi, I'm William Yang, Margaret Yang's father. This is my wife, Lucille. That kid's gonna burn this place down. You better believe it.
Well, the plans were never formally submitted to the city.
Were they supposed to be?
I assume so.
Too late now.
Program. Bennett. Bennett. Listen.
Schwartzman. Looks like Max pulled the first one on us.
I don't usually do this, but this play means a lot to me, and I wanted to make a dedication. So I'll just say that this play is dedicated to the memory of my mother, Eloise Fischer, and to Edward Appleby, a friend of a friend. Also, you'll find a pair of safety glasses and some earplugs underneath your seats. Please feel free to use them. Thank you very much. Ready?
To order the military forces of the United States to take out this is a different kind of war.
We are making trouble.
How long have you been in country, soldier?
I ain't even here, Sergeant. I'm Cheyenne, Wyoming.
Right on, brother.
How much time we got, Wood?
2 minutes.
All right, bring me some more ketchup very quickly, please.
But this is gonna look stupid.
No, it's not. It's gonna look real.
Latest opus.
It's good. But let's hope it's got a happy ending.
Adios, Esposito.
Adios, Sarge. Say a prayer for Sir Floyd. Wherever he is.
Semper Fi, soldier. Semper Fi.
Sic transit gloria. Maybe we'll meet again someday. When the fighting stops.
Tack him in back of cherries for moving it! Get him out! I don't know, but I'll pay for it!
Hello, Esposito.
Will you marry me late, John?
You bet I will.
Told me to wear a tie.
Congratulations,
Jay. Thank you very much, Mrs. Jay. I actually wrote a different version of the play 2 years ago, but I couldn't get it done over at Rushmore.
Oh, really? What?
Did it go?
No, a kid got his finger blown off during rehearsals.
A very good evening to you, Fishers. Hi.
Miss Cross would like to meet my father, Bert Fisher. He's a barber. This is my friend, Rosemary Cross.
Hello, Rosemary.
Nice to meet you at last class.
Of course you know, Mr. Bloom. I'd also like everyone to meet Mr. and Mrs. Yang. This is Margaret.
Hello, Margaret.
It's nice to meet you, Miss Cross.
I'm surprised they let him build a real campfire on stage. It's clearly a safety hazard. Well, last year he tried to raise piranhas.
Yeah, I know he did.
What
What'd you think, Mr. Little Jeans?
Best play ever, man.
I thought it was a very realistic performance.
Yeah? Fisher stepped over half my bloody lines.
That's funny,
I didn't notice.
It's blue. How are Ronnie and Donnie enjoying military school?
They love it. Lucky bastards.
I understand you're a neurosurgeon.
No, I'm a barber. But a lot of people make that mistake.
You were incredible tonight, Margaret. You were that poor girl.
Thank you. I loved it when you grabbed onto the bottom of the chopper as it was taking off.
That was totally improvised.
I know.
Can I ask you a question?
Of course.
Can you do an Australian accent? I'm working on something that set me out back.
I really feel like celebrating, you know?
Would you care to dance?
Oh, yes. I would love to.
Great.
What?
You're looking good, Bert.
Hello, Mr. Bloom.
Hello, Margaret. May I cut in? I haven't had a chance to cut a rug with your girlfriend.
Oh, your girlfriend.
Yes, I am. Find your own dance partner, Mr. Bloom. I'm spoken for.
No, it's okay. He's my friend.
Well, it pulled it off.
Yeah, it went okay. At least nobody got hurt.
Except you.
I didn't get hurt that bad.
Come on, you two, shake a leg.
Would you like to dance?
Yeah, but yeah, let's see if the DJ can play something.
Ruben!
The body.